this is not just my story. This is not about me. And I don't want you to make it about me. It's about you. It's about you. It's about your friends. It's about your relatives. It's about you and the future of your children. Sexual harassment, abuse, assault. These are the things that we as a society have learned to talk in whispered tones. But we don't realize the kind of lasting damage that it leaves on the psyche of victims. If they're not allowed to voice themselves, the very same sense of self-guilt, self-shame that is imposed on them, on victims, stifles not only their voice, but their spirits as well. And they then live with this kind of suffocation on a path of destruction while the culprits walk free. I want to put a message out to all those roadside Romeos who are present in all walks of life, who think they can just simply intimidate you, harass you, call goons on you and get away with it. This is not just about what result I'm seeking. Honestly, even I'm not sure what result I'm seeking, but I know there will be result. I know it's already has impacted a lot of people, and I want a situation where every guy or whoever it is who thinks that, you know, they can get away, that they should have this one thought that, hey, I'm not sure if I can get away with this. Because, you know, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, 20 years from now, she may wake up, she may find her strength to speak up, and I will be named and I will be shamed. For those who are wondering what my motive is, you know, this is my motive. The rest is up to you. You can use your instinct and use your intuition and use your heart and your feelings to really decide what you want to believe, what you want to support, and where you want to take this.
Hello and welcome to a special episode of Planet Bollywood. Hashtag We Are Listening campaign is creating buzz all over the country. And today in this special episode, we are going to talk about how celebs are raising their voice. So let's start the episode.
Thank you so much again for talking to us, Tanushree. It's again been a long, long day for you. Too many developments have obviously happened. But I want to know, how are you doing? It's been the fourth day. You've been talking throughout to a lot of people, to us, to a lot of other people, a lot of things, like you say. But how are you doing right now?
I am very hopeful that more and more people will come out in our support. Like I said before, this is not about me. This is about something that is rampant. And it's been happening for a long time, and nobody has ever come forward, and hence the culture of harassment has continued. Hmm. Not only in the film industry, but also across the board, everywhere. And we have to change that thought process that harassment is not even an offense.
Yeah.
And that is also the reason why I'm showing everybody the humane side of what one goes through. That it's not just a new story, it's not a new slash, it is about somebody's life. Because harassment, when it is pushed to a limit, in my case, it actually ended up with mob violence. So it can have long-term repercussions on a person. So this is something that has to be discouraged in society. You cannot have such an inflated ego that you cannot take no for an answer. So men have to be given that message across. And this movement is about that as well. So this is going to help not only if this comes forward and produces some tangible results, produces some disciplinary actions, produces some kind of hard-hitting messages, you know, sent across to this movement, it will encourage not only many people to come up and speak, but also it will pass a message on to people who are probably serial harassers and have been living, it's a part of their lifestyle. They will become careful because now they know they will be called out and named and shamed. So this is, in a way, also a public service initiative that started, with me speaking out my story. But it is now becoming a global phenomenon because there are a lot of support that is coming in from international quarters also. The story has been picked up by international press. And they are now starting to cover it because, you know, for the longest time they saw the silence that was happening in India. And I'm also getting calls from a few international journalists, international press that I've spoken to. And you will soon see stories coming out there. So it has a potential of becoming a global phenomena, and support can start pouring in from, you know, as far as America and UK, UAE, and these quarters. So I'm kind of hopeful, and you know, I want people to know that I'm there to speak, you know, and to hold the flame.
No, absolutely, and that's wonderful to hear, because it's so much more right now than just a story that was yours, right? We did the We Are Listening campaign sort of a thing with you, and, you know, we've got a lot of people who sort of obviously see, you know, that video was about you telling the world your story and how, what your real motive is, you know, how this is so much more than you. So thank you for doing that with us. You know, that is something that we hope will also encourage a lot more women to come forward. You know, Tanushree, again, you obviously see what is happening right now. You mentioned that there's the intimidation and the threats that are coming in from, you know, from Nana or his side about, you know, that she's going to send, you know, he's already sent, his advocate has given interviews where he said that he's already sent a legal notice to you. And of course, Nana again given interviews saying that how he's going to look at the media and you know, talk right into you know, talk to them directly, looking at their faces on around 7th or 8th October, answering all their questions. When you see all of that, you know, what is the person that comes to your mind, or what happened? What did you think of that?
Well, about him looking into the camera and whatnot, let me tell everybody and warn everybody, be prepared for an award-winning performance. So that is one thing I have to say. Second thing is, pathological liars can look into the camera, look into your eyes, and look into wherever you want them to look into, and still speak and spin the same web of lies that they are used to spinning. So why are we even discussing about that? But another thing that I want to address is about the advocate coming forward and saying that he's already sent me a legal notice. That is an absolute lie, because I have not received any legal notice, and this is the same thing that Nana and his then advocate had said back then also. That time also, he was threatening to sue me, but I'm still waiting to receive a legal notice from him. And the second point I want to raise is, what on what grounds?
Yeah.
These are threat and intimidation tactics, which I can see through, and I want everybody to see through. So for all those people who are wondering if they should come forward or not, when you come forward to tell your story, the person who you're naming and shaming is extremely afraid and shaken. Mm-hmm. And they're going to intimidate you, and they're trying to intimidate you into silence by using many, many different tactics. They're going to try and throw you off by using legal mumbo-jumbo, by using you know, a legal threat. Because they know how the law and order system of our country is. But the thing is, he will not want to be on an offensive.
Yeah.
Because the moment he starts that procedure, he has himself gotten stuck into the legal process. Somebody who's so... A criminal will always be afraid of the law. Remember this. Somebody who's innocent should not be afraid of the law. A criminal will always be. So he will always avoid being entangled in the law. But he will use the law to pose a threat on someone. So that is what he's doing. These are empty threats, and you know, I have gotten them before. I've gotten them 10 years ago. I'm getting them now, and I know exactly where they are going. They're not gonna go anywhere. So he can have his advocate or lawyer, or he can have whosoever come on TV channels and bluff it out. What I want to ask the TV channels is, why are you even allowing such a comedy to happen on your shows? It will remove credibility of your shows, because when you allow someone to come and speak on your show and say that we have already sent a legal notice and here I am telling you I have not received it, you know. So these people get proved a liar. So, you know, this is what I have to say.
No, you know, here, like you clearly say, absolutely, and like you're clearly saying, is that you haven't received a legal notice. It's extremely important to highlight this point, that how there are stories everywhere saying that legal notice has been sent and a legal case is being pursued. So, like you mentioned, it is obviously to create that environment. I mean, why don't you just
create
send the legal
environment
notice
of
first?
Fear.
And I'm saying, why don't you send the legal notice first and then bring it up, right? I mean, if you want to...
Exactly.
Isn't that the way to go about it?
Exactly. If you're really sending a legal notice to someone, you don't talk about it. You send it to that person, you let them receive it, and then you say it. Because another thing I would like to clear, Rudrani, when people in our country now, when they hear legal notice, they get very scared. A legal notice is simply a letter which has been drafted by a lawyer who has a license to practice law, has an LLB or whatever degrees that are required to practice that kind of law, and he can sit in front of his computer and form a letter. It is basically a lawyer's notice. A legal notice is not a court notice. You are not yet in court. You have 45 days to respond to that legal notice. So even if somebody does manage to send you a legal notice, whereas remember, when you're naming and shaming someone, they cannot send you a legal notice because A, you're exercising your rights to freedom. The Constitution gives us a very important right, the freedom of expression, where if something has happened to you, you have the right to express it. You have the right to speak it. So they cannot send you a legal notice for anything. So that is one point. And a legal notice is a lawyer's notice. The matter has not yet gone to court. You have 45 days to respond to it. And you can also send back a lawyer's notice.
Yeah.
So when people hear all this, they get intimidated because hamare desh ke jo sharif log hain, unko pata nahi hai sari cheezon ke bare mein. Main bhi intimidate ho gayi thi 10 saal pehle kyunki hum bhi sharif gharane se the, hum bhi sharif log the. Humko ye sab nahi pata tha ki police ka aur ye court kachari ka chakkar kya hota hai. तो उसने ये लीगल नोटिस भेजेंगे तुमको हम कोर्ट में लेके जाएंगे ये सब करके उसने मुझे डराए धमकाया उस वक्त तो मैं डर के धमक गई मैं दैट टुडे इट विल नॉट वर्क बिकॉज अब शराफत भी तो हमने छोड़ दी है ना इस तरह से लोगों के साथ अगर इफ यू हैव टू कॉम्बैट देम यू नो ये झूठ बोलकर कुछ भी बोलकर आपकी यू नो आपके बारे में उल्टा सीधा चलाकर अपनी काली करतूतों को छुपाने के लिए कुछ भी कर सकते हैं हराज करने के बाद गुंडों को बुलाया ताकि ये बाहर जाके गुस्से में बुलाया कि ये हमारे हाथ से निकल कैसे गई गुंडों को बुलाने के बाद मीडिया के सामने इंटरव्यू तो वैसे भी दे रहे थे ताकि मैं जाके कुछ ना बोलूं और मैं जाके कुछ बोल रही हूँ तो मेरी बातों को कोई ना सुने मुझे डिस्क्रेडिट करने के लिए आज भी वही किया जा रहा है 10 साल पहले भी उन्होंने वही किया था कोर्ट के नोटिस के थ्रेट भेजे थे यहाँ पे प्रोड्यूसर सामी सिद्दीकी जो खुद उस हरासमेंट में पार्टी था उसने प्रोड्यूसर एसोसिएशन में जाके मेरी कंप्लेन कर दी कि इसकी वजह से हमारा नुकसान हो गया 1 करोड़ का ठीक है तुम हरास करो सेट पे तुम परेशान करो और मैं उधर ही खड़ी रहूं मतलब मुझे भागने का भी हक नहीं है और उसके बाद वहां पे जाके कोर्ट के एसोसिएशन में केस कर दिया कि हमारा 1 करोड़ का नुकसान हो गया तो आप समझ सकते हैं कितना ज्यादा प्रेशर ये डालते हैं किसी के ऊपर भी जब कोई बोल रहा होता है ये अपने डर की वजह से क्योंकि एक बार किसी ने बोलना शुरू कर दिया है तो फिर तो काली करतूतें सारी बाहर आ जाएंगी तो वीजा आर एंटी थ्रेट वो जो प्रोड्यूसर्स एसोसिएशन का भी जो थ्रेट था उनमें भी उन्होंने कोई नोटिस नहीं भेजा मुझे मीटिंग में बुलाया वहां पे डरा धमकाया कि हम तो आप पे 1 करोड़ का जुर्माना और ये सब करने वाले हैं फिर उसका कुछ नहीं हुआ सिंटा में जो मीटिंग हुई हमारी तरफ से भी हम एक्टर एसोसिएशन की तरफ से भी कोई हेल्प नहीं मिली और प्रोड्यूसर एसोसिएशन ने भी इसको मैटर को आगे नहीं लिया लेकिन ये हमें उस स्पॉट में लाया गया ना प्रोड्यूसर एसोसिएशन ने एक्टर एसोसिएशन को बोला आपके एक्टर ने ऐसा ऐसा किया है तो अभी हम उस पर 1 करोड़ का हम दावा डाल रहे हैं तो डाला क्यों नहीं फिर दावा बोल बोल के बस छोड़ दिया और यहाँ पे नाना पाटेकर केस डालेंगे तुमको कोर्ट पे लेके जाएंगे हमारे बारे में ये सब बोल रही हो तो डाला क्यों नहीं नोटिस भेजना चाहिए था ना उस वक्त क्यों नहीं भेजा और अभी भी वही बोल रहे हैं अभी बोल रहे हो नोटिस भेजो तो भेज क्यों नहीं रहे हो नोटिस तो तुमको पता है तुम नोटिस देकर ही खुद फंस जाओगे बिकॉज यू आर नाउ यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू क्रिमिनल इंटिमिडेशन एंड हरासमेंट ऑफ विक्टिम एंड विटनेस जब कोई विटनेस या विक्टिम आगे आता है अपनी कहानी बोलने के लिए अगर कोई लॉयर और जिसके ऊपर अक्यूजेशन है अगर वही उसको डरा के धमका रहा है दैट मीन्स अभी एक और उस पर दफा लगेगी क्रिमिनल इंटिमिडेशन एंड हरासमेंट ऑफ विटनेस इज व्हाट दे आर डूइंग तो ये जो लॉयर है इसकी बार एसोसिएशन में अगर कंप्लेन कर दी जाए तो इसकी तो लाइसेंस रद्द हो जाएगी तो मैं ये बोलना चाहती हूँ कि ये जो माहौल क्रिएट किया जा रहा है, द एनवायरमेंट दैट इज गेटिंग क्रिएटेड, इट इज सो दैट कि बाकी जो लोग हैं ना जिसके साथ इससे बदतमीजी की है वो सामने ना आए. क्योंकि अभी इसके गिरेबान में झांक के देखो तो बहुत सारी काली करतूतें निकलेंगी. उसको डर है कि अभी ये तो 10 साल बाद आके फिर से बोल रही है, अब बाकियों ने बोलना शुरू कर दिया तो मेरी बैंड बच जाएगी. तो ये सारा बुना जा रहा है, स्मियर कैंपेन जो हो रहा है मेरे बारे में, प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेस रखे जा रहे हैं, उल्टी सीधी बातें बोली जा रही है. दिस इज ऑल अ पार्ट ऑफ स्मियर कैंपेन, ये बोलने के लिए कि भैया ये आई है तो देखो इसके ऊपर मैं नोटिस डाल रहा हूँ, स्मियर कैंपेन इसके बारे में सारा उल्टा सीधा बोल रहा हूँ तो तुम्हारे साथ भी वैसा होगा. सो आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेल एवरीबडी एल्स हू थिंकिंग टू कम फॉरवर्ड, डू नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ दिस. उसके पास कुछ नहीं है, नोटिस भी नहीं आया है और भेजेगा भी नहीं. और जो ये स्मियर कैंपेन हो रहा है, उन्होंने जिसको आगे किया है उसकी खुद की कोई क्रेडिबिलिटी नहीं है.
इन आवर लेटेस्ट मोमेंट, सॉरी आई कट यू, प्लीज गो अहेड.
सो दिस इज बेसिकली एन एफर्ट टू क्रिएट एन एनवायरमेंट ऑफ फियर सो दैट अदर पीपल हु हैड सिमिलर एक्सपीरियंसेस विद हिम डू नॉट कम फॉरवर्ड. बिकॉज देयर आर मेनी 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 पीपल दैट वी हैव हर्ड अनऑफिशियली. But we cannot be the ones to talk about it, because unless and until the people come forward themselves and tell their own story in their own words, we cannot be telling their story. That step you have to take yourself. We can be here. I have been going through this all over again. Do you think it's easy for me? No, it's not. It was not easy back then 10 years ago, and it is not easy even today. My parents are getting triggered emotionally seeing all of this happen again. They have seen all of this happen again. The fear tactic, the intimidation tactic, the threats, you know, the smear campaigns, everything they have seen in the past, and they were happy and satisfied that I had settled abroad. I was living in the US, I was working in the US, and they didn't want me to ever come back over here into this Bollywood and this scene. They simply called me here for a holiday because I was between apartment shifting and all that was going on. So they simply said, come, have a holiday with us and go back. They didn't even want me getting involved in the press or anything. But this is happening. Somehow we have come to this stage where this is happening. And now they are remembering all the things that happened to them in the past. And it is triggering their emotions. It is triggering their, you know, feelings. And it is horrible to see them go through that. I'm counseling them as well. But this is what exactly happened back then. The fear and intimidation tactic to not let others come forward and speak. Do not fall for this trap and this illusion. If you have something to say, you come forward, because he has no power anymore. There is nobody from the industry who is even coming forward and supporting him.
Planet Bollywood mein filhal waqt hai chote se break ka. Break ke baad ye special episode rahega jari.
You know, from here, do not be afraid. We'd also, like we said, via Zoom, would like to empower these voices also to come forward and tell us their stories. We'd like to provide a platform, because it's important to hear them out and not to let them feel so unsafe and feel that, you know, their voices can be heard. On that note, I'd like to ask you, you know, we spoke about people discussing what he's done in the past on social media. I think you've seen what Renuka Shahane also put up a Facebook post, you know, in your support. And there's a lot of things that she said, you know. Would you want to tell me what you thought about that?
I thought Renuka Shahane's perspective was a very, very intelligent perspective. She has really put thought into the matter, and she is letting people see the plain, simple fact that nothing warranties violence. When she said that would there be earth-shattering consequences if they had removed the steps, which is a fact. Would there have been earth-shattering consequences if they had changed the step or removed the step altogether? Mm. Considering the fact that in my version of the truth, you know, if you even choose to call it that, it was supposed to be a solo song sequence. It was not supposed to be a duet. And another thing, when I had complained to Ganesh Acharya and the director and producer initially, they also had acknowledged it, that we don't know why he's on set, but he's a senior actor, we cannot tell him to leave. What do? We are also helpless. They had said that to me. Unfortunately, I don't have audio recordings, because I never knew that these people are coming from such a place where they will all gang up against me. But they had said that to me, that we also don't know what to do. He's on set. How do we tell him to leave? But we'll handle it. Don't worry. It's going to be fine. But 2 hours later, when I went back on set, the whole scenario had changed. They were no longer on my side or trying to help or trying to make things better. They were now insisting on me doing this sleazy step, which came out of nowhere. So that's, you know, what it is. Yeah. So Renuka's point was very, very valid. She brought it up that nothing in the world warranties calling any kind of political party or pressure. That itself proves guilt. And on a 23-year-old girl, like I was in her early 20s, on a young girl, like, what part of the world, what law of the world, what religion and what community condones such a thing? In our country, a lot of times people stand together in solidarity because of religious sentiments and community sentiments and whatnot. But tell me this, which part of your humanity allows you to be okay with that? Regardless of whatever religion you have and whatever community you follow and whatever fraternity you belong to, what part of your humanity and consciousness allows this and thinks it's okay and thinks that it is not something to be appalled by?
Planet Bollywood ki ye khas peshkash jari rahegi ek chote se break ke baad. So don't go anywhere.
I think rightly said, and she mentions it, and it was a very, very well-worded post. I think that definitely showed genuine support from that is pouring in as well. And, you know, I think that is going to keep this movement sort of going. You know, I'd also like to bring up, you mentioned the point about how your parents are feeling the pressure. You know, it's amazing that you are still, you know, you're still so composed about what's happening again. Like you say, it's reliving the trauma of what happened 10 years back. You know, what happened 10 years ago, and it's never easy to do that. But, you know, you mentioned that, and I want to know how are they doing. And it really must be difficult for them because while you are so strong, you know, your father had to go even then so many times to the, you know, to the court. You know, he was in the jail. He, you know, he was taken, all of that.
Cop station.
To the station. Sorry. Yeah.
Your father. He was discouraged and threatened from even going to the court.
Correct. Yeah. So your father had to go so many times to the cop station, you know, to the police station.
Because our spot boy and the hairdresser were getting harassed.
Correct. So I'm saying, tell me what happened. You know, you mentioned how, you know, how sort of worried they are right now.
You know, I want everybody to remember that they were in the car with me when I was attacked by the mob. So when the harassment was happening on the set, and once I stormed out of the set and once I was in my vanity van, I called my mom and dad to come to the set and try and help me sort out the situation. My manager was also there, right? So I now wanted older people who are older than me to handle the situation because I was at my wit's end handling these old men, you know. Nana Patekar, Ganesh Acharya, Sami Siddiqui and Rakesh Sarang, they were like old men up against, I was like in my early 20s. Okay. So they were pressurizing me to do that sleazy step with Nana Patekar, and they were calling me unprofessional on my face. That this is very unprofessional, you have to do this step. And that's when I stormed out. Because they were putting psychological pressure, all kinds of pressure, they were just simply disregarding the fact that this is not supposed to happen. Yeah. And completely disregarding the fact that I had complained about him a couple of hours ago. And they had assured me that they will do something about it. Okay. So I obviously had to now call my parents that they can communicate on an adult level how to sort out this problem. Because they were manipulating me. They were, you know,
intimidating.
They were twisting, they were playing with words, you know. And being a young actress in the industry, this is something that you face very often. When you don't comply to certain demands, you are called unprofessional, you are called a tantrum queen, you are called a difficult person, you are called a moofot, you are called all kinds of things. Regardless of the fact that you could be the most professional person in that moment on that set. And women in our industry, I can vouch for this. Even women that did not come out in my support, and even women who I am disappointed in them that they are not taking any stand on this and they are not supporting me. But even for those, I can say that the women of this film industry are more professional than the men, because we cannot afford to be unprofessional. We cannot afford to be even 5 minutes late. The hero can come hours late. He cannot show up on set at all. some actors of this old generation, they are drunk on the sets half the time. They drink, they come to the sets, they sit in their vanity vans and they drink. Then they come out and they are stoned and drunk. But nobody says anything. But if a woman comes, and if a woman has to be like we are like military cadets. Everything has to be perfect. You cannot say one thing out of line. You cannot do anything out of line. If you forget your lines once, someone can scream at you. At least this is what happens when you're new. Once you become a big star, then of course you have a clout and no one gets to say anything. But when actresses are new, they get screamed at for getting one line wrong. 5 minutes if you're late, you will be called unprofessional on your face while you're waiting on the set. After coming 5 minutes late, you've been waiting on the set for 5 hours and the shooting has still not started. Or somebody has come late. But, you know, when they finally decide to arrive on set, they are welcomed with open arms as if like a prince has arrived. So women in this industry cannot afford to be unprofessional, and unprofessional is a very far end of the spectrum. You cannot afford to even fall sick. I have shot for movies when I've had 104 temperature, Rudrani. I've had temperature and I've had fever and I have not had the courage to say that I'm sick and I want to go home, because then they would say that drama kar rahi hai, natak kar rahi hai. I heard it happened on one film set.
That's really sad.
I said that I'm sick. My dad was there on that outdoor shoot. He said that, you know, she's sick, she needs to take her antibiotics, she's not well. They would make me shoot for like hours on end, not give me lunch breaks, not give me, you know, dinner breaks. My dad would be holding the plate and running behind me, you know, like how mothers do that. My dad is almost like a mother to me, you know. He would be running behind the plate with a khana, roti in his hand. Between the takes, he's like, just khalo thoda thai. Because my dad is a successful professional. He is in at the top of his field. But when he sees his daughter not even getting food on the set, because they are like, no, no, we have to take this shot. Oh, we have to take this shot. We don't have time. Light is going down. I've seen my dad be like, you know, just khalo, ek roti khalo bas abhi. And because he didn't want the antibiotics to, you know, become acidic in my body. I had such high fever. Finally, my body gave up and I collapsed. And then the producers, this was Rakib, that movie that I did. Producers came, they didn't even bother to come inside the room and see how I'm doing. They were standing outside the room and my pot and my hairdresser heard them saying, kuch nahi drama kar rahi hai, usko shooting nahi kar rahi. After seeing everything, after calling the doctor came and gave me injections. And, you know, when I heard that, I said, you know what, I don't want them to think that I'm my drama kar rahi hu. I told the doctor, is there something that you can give me that I can immediately jump out of bed? He's like, there is nothing in the world I can give you that can make you immediately jump out of bed. It will at least take, the injection I can give you, it will at least take like half an hour or an hour to put life into your body. I said, do it, give it to me. He's like, you know, in such high fever cases, injections are not a good option. You just take some protein and I'll give you some other medicines. You are exhausted, you know, you have not been eating and this is simply a result of exhaustion. I said, no, give me the injection. I want to go back and finish today's shoot. And then I will collapse. Because my pride was hurt that somebody can even say that. So I'm saying that my story, this is not new. When you're new in the industry, when you don't come from a background, when you don't have the mummies and the papas and the chachas and the chachis, this happens. So for all those people in the industry who are simply watching the drama unfold, you have never gone through this because you came with a silver spoon in your mouth, bloody. Everybody that you approached, people approached you for film projects, direct our film, no. Star in our film, no. Because your uncles and chachas and pere paune and you know, all of that happened. These are all your buddies. Not for us. We've had to come into this city, build our credibility as a Miss India, as a model, music video, then get one movie offer, and then build one step at a time. So when somebody comes like this and destroys our credibility, it hurts. You did not have to go through all this. No. You did not get mistreated on the set and cramped on set and shooting in high fever. You get one little sneeze you'll have and somebody from your big-ass household will call up and say, baby, you're shooting me kar rahi hai. And that's it. You will be taken back home in your luxury Mercedes, in your luxury mansion, and you will take the rest of the day off and probably the rest of the week off. We did not have that luxury. Those of us who are from outside the industry, we've shot fever no matter what, and we still have to hear things like drama kar rahi hai. So when you have gone through all of that and you have maintained, you have come to a position, and then something like this happens on a set, it hurts. Yeah. So if you think, if you are not able to understand it, it's because you've not been through it, and you will probably never will. But that doesn't make my story wrong. That doesn't make me a liar. Mm. That makes you privileged.
Yeah.
And me a survivor and a fighter.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Planet Bollywood में फिलहाल वक्त है एक छोटे से ब्रेक का, लेकिन आप कहीं मत जाइएगा क्योंकि ब्रेक के बाद बाकी है बहुत कुछ खास.
We were, and like I said, I think also try to bring that up to you about what things are feeling right now. You know, are they in a state of complete distress, and are they worried? You know, how are they doing?
Yes, yes, because they remember everything play out exactly the way it's playing out now. The threat, the intimidation, you know, a crafty woman coming forward, spewing abuses, and spinning matlab character assassination to another level. Like, this is like major smear campaign. They've seen through all of this. The words are different. Back in the day, the words that were used to smear me was drama queen, tantrum throw careers, unprofessional and whatnot. Now the words are different. Okay, I will not even address it because I think the source which is coming from is so, lacks so much credibility, is completely uncredible that, you know, I don't even want to give it credibility by mentioning it. Mm. But I'm just saying that the same thing, you know, screaming and shouting does not make something true. Yelling at the top of your voice does not make something true. And my question is that this is exactly what happened. So they are remembering it. They are getting triggered by it. I am their child. No matter how old I get, I will always be their child.
Hmm.
They have seen me go through all of this, and they were inside the car when the car was being attacked. So they themselves have gone through the trauma. And perhaps I walked the spiritual path, and I had a lot of opportunities to heal myself and come out of this. You know. So today, when I'm speaking out about this incident, a lot of emotional charge that is associated with it is not there anymore. You know, a lot of the triggers are have become very weak. But for them, the other day, my mom got triggered. She, her face went red. She got suddenly very emotional and hyper, and she went and she went inside the kitchen. And I was like, I could see that they were getting triggered by this trauma because they feel like they're going to get away with it this time also. Because the same thing, the same tactics they employed last time, it's just difference being that it's, it may be working on other people, it's not working on me.
Mm.
I'm way too aware, way too enlightened, I've been through way too much, and I've overcome way too much, and I have way too much grace on me of God to fall for this shit all over again. That's not going to happen. I am not alone. Even if the whole industry stands by watching, even if the media stands by watching, which the media is not, the media is actually the wind beneath my sails, you know, pushing it forward. The whole thing. But I'm saying, even if nobody stands by me, I will still stand here talking, because it's not me who's giving me the strength to speak out. There is something much, much larger than me, much, much higher than me, that is now propelling me to speak and come forward. You know, it's propelling me towards justice. I believe I will get some kind of justice, and I will believe I will get some kind of retribution. I know it in my bones, and I know it in my spirit. And it's bigger than me.
You know, talking about retribution, we're talking about results. And I think, you know, if you'd like to tell everybody about why it's important, why is it that it upsets so much, you know, when industry people are still doing films with Ms. Patekar and with Tana, and, you know, posting pictures and still doing it. And while there are stories, and I read an article where a source close to Farah says that she was not being insensitive and she was unaware when post up and all of that. And of course, and then a Krithi Saran puts a picture from this, which does not. So, I mean, obviously, where what's happening, but I'm saying that, you know, it comes again. Sort of say that we are not going to work with him is important.
See, this is not, I want to tell people who are dumb enough to say that, you know, the picture didn't mean that I'm in support. No, it's not about the picture, duh. You fool, it's not about the picture. It's about the fact that you're still working with that man. Don't you get it? Being a woman, don't you get it? haven't you also been harassed enough? And now, come on, don't be such a fake and a liar by saying that your life has been a bed of roses. You have given interviews in the past where you have spoken about your struggles. You have also gone through moments where people have gotten away perhaps by troubling you. And harassment is not new in our industry. Everybody knows that. Men go through it, women go through it, everybody goes through it. So when you're taking a stand, oh my God, it's just a picture. No, it's not about the picture. It's about the fact that you being in a position of power and you have the position to say, no, I'm not going to work with this actor. You still go ahead and you're cocky enough to post a picture and rub it on my face. It means that it is of no consequence to you that another human being has been troubled so much by this very person who's right next to you, and you are the one who will come forward and speak about women's empowerment and whatnot. That is what is disgusting. You are showing your true colors to all your fans and all the people who have always believed that you have a certain character. Now you are exposing yourself. That is what it is about. So let's just stop pretending. You know, the comebacks that people are coming with now is like amazing. Like, I don't even know what to say to it. It's like the kind of things that some of the people in the industry have to say now, it is beyond ridiculous. Like, you really think I've come from another planet that nobody sees what you're really doing? Everybody is seeing what you're doing. The ones who genuinely come across, everybody is seeing that what they're doing also. Their words are drenched in genuinity. Their words are drenched in compassion. The ones who come forward, they are revealing what kind of heart they have. They are revealing what kind of compassion they have. They are revealing their genuinity. That also people can see. And these fake ones, you know, all the fakes of Bollywood are also getting exposed.
And this is also an opportunity, more than opportunity. This is also the time when producers who usually take, you know, are, again, people of extreme power, who are, you know, people who in the industry who can take a call of deciding, you know, we have two eyewitnesses sort of coming forward and, you know, supporting what happened there, that they are dating your statement. So, you know, it is important to do that and to generate a conversation that a stand needs to be taken, a disciplinary action needs to be taken, where a lot of producers, including the ones who are producing Houseful 4 and other movies that have been planned, that, you know, do you want to take a call like that and take a strong stand and show where you stand as a person, isn't it?
Yeah, of course. Who's the producer of this movie, Houseful?
I think it's the Nadiadwala, no? Sajid Nadiadwala.
I want to pose a question to him. Have you no conscience? Or are you also going to turn around and give me the same mumbo jumbo of, you know, let's see investigation, let's see this, that? I mean, you should know more than anybody else. In this country, you can get away with murder also, but no investigation leads anywhere. So what are you talking about? So this industry people, when they say such things, no, oh, let's see where the investigation leads and let's see where this and that's bullshit. You know very well the character of this person that you have employed in your movie. Everybody knows and everybody talks about it. And here is this person coming forward and speaking how deeply it has affected her, because this guy not only harassed, but he had the audacity to call a violent group, violent mob upon her because she chose to walk away. She fall for that trap. And you don't think that that is condonable? Perhaps you grew up in an environment, perhaps you have been used to working in an environment where harassment is normal. But is a mob attack on a girl normal? On a 20-something girl? How old are your daughters? Would you be okay if that happens to them? And would you be okay if someone who did that got away with it? Perhaps you cannot understand the compassion because your daughters are probably moving around with police security. Well, other people's daughters come to movie sets for working in a safe environment, and then this is what happens to them. So I'm posing this question to everybody associated with that film. Have shame, guys. Have shame. Someday all of this money and success and all of this will not matter. When life hits you hard, you are going to call upon God to help you, and that day you will be questioned, what did you do when someone asked you for help? Or have you all any which has given up hopes of ever seeing that day where you will be standing face to face with God? What a formidable group this is. Akshay Kumar, Nana Patekar, Sajid Nadiadwala, and Sajid Khan's sister. What a formidable group. Conscience is massively lacking in this group.
Well, Thank you so much, Tanushree. And there's a lot of important points that you've discussed here. And like we always hope, that we hope more voices come forward like you. And it is important. It's the need of the hour. And I really, really hope, we hope that soon this movement becomes way bigger. It is already there and we get to see so much more results. Thank you once again, Tanushree.
प्लैनेट बॉलीवुड के इस स्पेशल एपिसोड में फिलहाल के लिए बस इतना ही। कल शाम 7 बजे देखना ना भूलिएगा हमारा एक और एक्सक्लूसिव रेवलेशन ऑन दिस बर्निंग टॉपिक। टिल देन कीप वॉचिंग ज़ूम।